My partners and I founded Alta Motors in 2010 around a shared vision of creating motorcycles that were simply superior to the gas equivalents. Alta Motors is an electric vehicle manufacturer based in San Francisco, California. Our first product is a race-level electric motocross bike. And because it's electric, there's also a street legal version of it that is potentially the fastest urban vehicle on the planet. As CEO, ultimately I'm responsible for everything that happens under our roof, but my day-to-day is primarily running the business side and keeping everything out of the way of our design and engineering team to let them do what they do best. Managing an operation like this is not easy, and it requires a lot of multidisciplinary thinking. To do this successfully, you're combining business, technology, design, and a really in-depth understanding of the consumer space as well. In high school, I took, of course, the standard coursework. When I actually went off campus and took classes at a local university in philosophy and logic. Oftentimes in the classroom, we were too focused on the very specific rules and learning a really specific fact rather than learning an understanding of how to use all of the tools and how to put them into a broader context. I have an art and an engineering background. I worked in business consulting. We have to have under one roof all of those different skill sets. Some of the tools that we use and some of the parts that we build are still built manually, and so this is a manual lathe. All of us here come from somewhat of a product design background, so for us it all starts with what does the consumer really want, really need, what are they going to benefit from. Then you move through the steps of can we deliver on that, how do we deliver on that, and start sketching out concepts. And from concept design, you then start to test those concepts either by building them out and actually functionally using them and seeing if they perform the way that you want them to, or building them out virtually.
So not only does this platen rotate, but each one of the tombstones will actually rotate 90 degree increments in order to provide a tooling plane for each side of the tombstone.
Open-ended problems are the types of problems students will face in the real world, and forcing students to learn how to function in ambiguity and find their own answers, and that there isn't necessarily any one right answer, but there might be better and worse answers, I think that's really valuable. And don't be afraid to find your own path to the end that you want to pursue. You're not going to get it right on the first try, but you can make almost any job a dream job by looking for opportunities to do more, to go beyond, to create things that people aren't asking you for yet, but that you might recognize a need for.